I will be going over multiplying monomials. The first example we have here, -5m^5 n^3 times 4m^2 n^6. We have two monomials being multiplied by each other. When we multiply monomials, we want to group the numbers together and then the variables that have the same letter together as well. And then with the numbers, we're going to multiply them. And then with the variables, we are multiplying the variables, but the rule is to add the powers on those variables. So we have -5 times 4, m^5 times m^2, and then n^3 times n^6. We are multiplying the variables, but the powers we need to add. Now you can always expand. m^5 is 5m's. m^2 is 2m's. So we have a total of 7m's. That's why you add the powers. So now working it all out, we get -20m^7 and then n^3 times n^6 is to the 9th. The next one, we have the power of a product. We have a monomial that is taken to a power. When we take a power of a power, we're going to multiply those powers. The first thing that we need to do in this case is we need to distribute that power of 3 to everything in the parentheses. So -4^3, x^3, y^3, z^5. Each item gets that power of 3. Now notice the negative 4 got the power of 3 as well. It did not have a power, we just applied it. And then y did not have a power, we just applied that power of 3. Now the rule says we multiply the powers here. So if you need to expand it, just taking the first one, x^3, that means x^3 multiplied 3 times. And remember, when we multiply monomials, we add the powers. So 3 + 3 + 3 = 9. So if you need to expand it, you can. So now working it all out, -4^3, -4 × -4 × -4 = -64. x^3, 3 × 3 = 9. y^3, bring it down. z^5, 5 × 3 = 15. So when you are taking the power of a product, you're going to multiply the powers that are on those variables. And then the last example, we have a combination of both. We have two monomials being multiplied, but first they have powers attached to them. We need to take care of those powers first. Remember, with order of operation, exponents come before multiplication. So for the first one, we're going to distribute this power of 2 to everything in the parentheses. The second one, we're going to distribute this power of 3 to everything in the parentheses. So we get 3^2, r^4, s^7. The second one, we distribute the power of 3. 2^3, r^3, s^2. Notice that this r, it did not have a power, so we just have r^3. Then we work that part out. 3 × 9, 3 × 3 = 9. r^4, 4 × 2 = 8. s^7, 7 × 2 = 14. Then 2^3, 2 × 2 × 2 = 8. r^3. Then s^2, 2 × 3 = 6. So now we have worked out the power of the products. Now we're going to multiply those two monomials. Remember, when we multiply the monomials, we're going to group the numbers together. We're going to group the variables with the same letters together. And then we're going to add the powers on those variables. So we get 9 × 8 = 72, r^8 × r^3 = 11, s to the 14th times s to the 6th is to the 20th. So when we multiply the variables, we add the powers. But when we have a power taken to a power, we multiply the powers. I hope you understood everything that I went over in this video. If you have any more questions, please see your instructor.